Well, the economy in the tanks and the market's down, there's no better time than now to start building up your savings. I'll tell you how to do that and where to safely store your cash coming up on this episode of 2 Minute Finance. Financial experts have always said it's important to keep about 6 months of savings on hand in case of emergency. But between loan obligations, losing your job, and other expenses, is 6 months still really enough? It's important to think of a savings account not in terms of number of months can carry you over, but in terms of a regular place to contribute your money. And the best place to get that money is from your paycheck by deducting 5 to 10% of your paycheck every month and putting it directly into a savings account.
If you haven't already, ask your employer to direct deposit your paycheck into your checking account. Then ask your bank to sweep that money into a savings account immediately afterwards. It's an easy process to set up on a reoccurring basis, so you can set it and forget it.
Now remember, 5 to 10% is only a guideline. You've got to find a number you're comfortable with. So for example, let's say $150 a month or $75 per paycheck. Now let's take a look at how that small monthly contribution turns out 2 years from now. If you contribute $150 a month for 2 years at an interest rate of 3%, you'll have $5,163.97 at the end of 24 months, more than enough to cover yourself for a few months if there was a sudden change in your life. So the next question you might be asking is, where do I put my money in the long term so it's safe? Well, I like CDs or certificate of deposits. They're FDIC insured for up to $250,000 until December 2009, when that reverts back to $100,000 of protection, and they earn a relatively higher amount of interest than just leaving your money into a savings account. But remember, CDs lock your money in for a certain term. If you take your money out during that term, you will lose the interest you earn in that period. I'll explain more about CDs in a future episode.
I recommend looking at online banks and credit unions for CDs and savings accounts. They typically pay a higher rate of interest with lower opening balance requirements and are typically easier to deal with, albeit by telephone or email only.
The most important thing is to continue to regularly contribute to your savings account. If you get that Christmas bonus, take half of it and put it in the savings account and take the other half and spend it. If you didn't go out to that movie that you really wanted to see, put that money into your savings account because every little bit helps. For more information and resources on savings accounts and CDs and how to save, visit my website at 2MinuteFinance.com. In San Francisco, overlooking the Bay Bridge, I'm Bobby Lee for 2 Minute Finance.